Hello and welcome to the session on Educational Management. Introduction to Educational Management. The term management is familiar to most of us. You might have heard it being used in several contexts. For example, you may be familiar with terms such as business management, finance management, resource management, etc. In this unit, we will examine what management means in education. We usually associate education with scholastic activities, but management is an important non-scholastic aspect of education. It is essential for the overall effectiveness of instructional and learning process. By the end of this unit, you will be able to define management, define educational management, examine the scope of educational management, state the objectives of educational management, identify the functions of educational management, understand the different types of educational management, etc. What is management? Boiled down to essentials, the word management means the act of getting work done. The term refers to a governing body's efforts to steer an organization towards achieving specific goals through certain process. The process through which the predetermined goals are achieved involves planning, decision making, organizing, motivating, controlling, leading, performance appraisal, human resource development, and management, etc. Though the concept of management is normally associated with corporates and industries, it is gaining importance in the fast changing educational scenario. What is educational management? We all know that our formal education demands organized structure to attain its goals. We need trained teachers, quality infrastructure, and a healthy academic culture to ensure that the students who attend the program are ready to perform their future social roles. To attain this requirement, we need to have a good structure and a good management program in place in every education institution. This is why we say educational management needs collective human effort. Though we consider the head of each educational institution as the person who handles the management activities, it requires collective effort from teachers, students, parents, and other community members to realize the goal. We even require modern computer technologies to make the educational management process fall in place. The educational management, apparently a new and distinct branch of study, revolves around the purpose or the aims of education itself. Most of the time, the goals and the aims of an educational institution are designed by the principal in association with senior colleagues or sometimes in consultation with a small group of stakeholders. Typically, the goals of schools and other education institutions are influenced by external bodies. They mostly have a national or state curriculum to follow, leaving them a very little chance to shape their own goals and objectives. Educational management theory and practice. There are two ways to approach educational management. One way is to look at it as a theory that includes the knowledge and the principles related to managing an educational organization. The second way would be the practical sides of the theory, which includes human relations and communication, management of material, human and financial resources, and implementing policies in such a way that the pre-mediated goals are achieved. Educational management and administration. Before we get into an in-depth analysis of educational management, let us understand the difference between administration and management. It is defined that educational administration focuses more on conforming to rules and regulations. Administration always requires a boss who makes sure of the maintenance of order and discipline while exercising control. On the other hand, education management gives emphasis to democratization of decision making and policy formulation. Educational management focuses on bringing improvements to the system by formulating relevant policies. A manager, unlike the administrator, is considered as one among the staff and as a guide or philosopher. Even though there is this subtle differences of meanings attached to these terms, most others tend to interchangeably use these terms. The scope of educational management. The scope of educational management is immense, and like education itself, it keeps on evolving and changing. The scope of educational management is designed to foster all the major aspects of education given below: planning, organizing, directing and motivating, coordination and evaluation. The manager of an educational institution plans the activities and programs that help the institution achieve its predetermined goals and aims. He or she streamlines and coordinates the activities of teachers and other team members. The manager also devises a periodical evaluation method to ensure that stipulated goal is achieved within the given time frame. He or she leads the team from the front, constantly motivating and directing the teachers and the students to work harder towards realizing the aims and objectives put forward by the institution. We will be explaining these aspects of educational management in detail in the third module. In addition to the above mentioned five aspects of management, there is one more component we need to take into consideration, that is utilization of resources such as human resources, material resources and financial resources. The realization of the objectives and aims of any institution depends upon the effective management of available resources. Hence, we cannot leave out this major factor while considering the scope of educational management. The management of education covers all levels of education, including pre-primary, primary, university level and professional education. Educational management is absolutely necessary to ensure the smooth functioning of formal, non-formal and mass education. The management of various levels of education, such as central, state, district, institutional and the level of private bodies, all come under the scope of educational management. Objectives of educational management. The objectives of educational management are as follows: to offer good education. It means providing students with quality education at an affordable cost. The management team strives to provide the students with the right kind of education by deploying the best teachers at desk. By offering good education to its students, every management strives to equip the students to meet challenges of life, transforming them into better human beings, to bring qualitative improvement to the education system. Only by bringing in qualitative improvement to the ever-changing education scenario, any institution can provide its students with good education. Hence, bringing innovation and improvement to the policies and system is another important objective of educational management: to offer quality education to as many students as possible. The third objective of the educational management is to impart education to as many students as possible. This objective is based on the idea of quantitative expansion of education. At the state and district level, the responsible authorities make education accessible to a wide number of students by setting up schools at walkable distances and by equipping each school with quality teaching staff and other necessary infrastructure. At the university level, it means expanding the reach of the institution by opening more departments or introducing new branches of studies, as well as recruiting additional teaching staff. To attain this objective, along with recruiting teaching staff, the management also has to provide the students with state-of-the-art facilities such as libraries and labs, to develop a healthy working environment for teachers. To impart quality education, educational management should focus on fostering a healthy working environment for the teachers. The system should aim at facilitating professional development and ethics of teachers. They should be given proper facilities and freedom to conduct their job. Teachers should be given incentives based on their performance, which will help cultivate a healthy competition amongst them to try out innovative ideas and teaching methods, to develop high moral and harmony among teachers. The success of educational management lies in integrating resources of different talent levels to achieve the greater goal put forward by the institution. An educational management program becomes successful when the management team succeeds in cultivating harmony and high group morale among the manpower to ensure the optimum use of available resources. As already mentioned, in the scope of educational management, every management program should aim at utilizing the available human, material and financial resources to their maximum to achieve the predetermined goal, to improve the relations with the community. Every educational management program should aim to bridge the gap between teachers, students, parents and the community. That is the only way to make education accessible to maximum number of people. Only by maintaining and getting community support, management can facilitate the quantitative expansion of education. To offer a healthy academic culture in the institution, another important objective of the educational management is to provide a healthy academic culture to its students by putting democratic administrative process and ethical professional practices. The management tries to foster a healthy academic and social culture in the institution, which in turn will improve the quality of education. To offer effective management solutions, this is the major objective of any educational management program. The manager makes the operations efficient and smooth so that each individual student can benefit from the educational program any institution is offering. Functions of educational management. As we have already seen in the introduction, we know that management has different aspects which are necessary to ensure that the program could realize its goals. Let us discuss the aspects in detail. Planning. Planning is all about determining well in advance what is needed to be achieved and how to achieve them. A plan has three major components: details of what needs to be achieved in the future, the actions involved in the process, and identifying a person to implement the actions. Planning can be done for long term or short term, and it has to be goal oriented, and the goal has to be achievable, relevant, and should not be vague. We will discuss educational planning in detail in one of the coming chapters. Organizing. The second important function of educational management is organizing. Only a great organizer can be a great manager, as organizing is essential to achieve the already determined objectives and goals. To achieve the plan, one requires streamlining the teachers and other resources perfectly. The manager can assign certain roles and responsibilities to competent teachers, which will help strike a balance between resources of different skill levels. It is an organizer who ensures the cooperation of each and every resource of different skill levels to achieve the goals and objectives of the institution. Motivating. Keep the human resource motivated is another important function of the management. Only through motivation, the management can make the teachers work hard to achieve any predetermined goal within a stipulated time frame. Motivation can be achieved by honoring teachers who perform well. Rewards, recognitions, and awards are the best way to motivate the workforce. The management should always be careful to foster a healthy competition among the teachers. Directing. Another important function of any educational management is directing the available human resource through the right path. The manager plays the role of leader, under whose guidance members of an organization perform the task assigned to them to achieve the target. Coordinating. To achieve a plan, it requires teamwork, which means there will be a number of people working on multiple tasks, and coordinating all the activities done by different people is important in achieving the objectives. Monitoring and controlling. This is another major function of management. All the activities done by various teachers must be monitored constantly to ensure that every resource has understood the plan rightly and is on the right path and schedule. Through constant monitoring and controlling, a goal can be achieved without much hassle. Evaluation. Evaluation is the last but most important function of an educational management program. To ensure that a plan is successful, every manager has to periodically review and evaluate the performance of each resource. This way, the manager can understand to what extent the plan has been achieved or if they are still within the schedule, etc. The evaluation has to be objective, periodical, and comprehensive, and should be a part of the plan. Only with an objective evaluation, one can understand the strength and weaknesses of resources as well as the plan itself. An evaluation should also provide scope for improvement in the plan and operations by diagnosing and identifying the shortcomings of the plan if there are any. Timely recording and reporting of progress will make evaluation process hassle-free. To ensure any educational management program is a success, along with the above mentioned functions, a manager or the person who heads the operations must be able to make a systematic assessment of the future conditions by evaluating the available data on the present conditions of the system. The manager must be able to take the right decisions at the right time. Types of educational management. Educational management can be classified into two: participatory and non-participatory management. This classification is based on the participation of people in the management process. Participatory management. Participatory management is a form of management that is more decentralized and democratic as it involves people participation. In this form of management, from administrators to community members, from teachers to students, everyone actively participate in the core areas of management such as planning, implementing, and evaluating. In the Indian scenario, participatory management not only involves the participation of students, teachers, and community members, but the participation of central and state governments. In the management process, both the governments work in partnership where they together formulate policies and programs. When it comes to the implementation of these policies at the state level, district and block level officers participate in the operational process. When talking about participatory management, we can't overlook the changes the National Policy of Education or NPE 1998, modified in 1992, and Ramamurthy Committee report of 1990 brought into the educational management scenario. The National Policy of Education or NPE. NPE stresses the importance of people participation in education, including the participation of NGOs. According to NPE, participation of people and NGOs are important for the universalization of formal, non-formal, elementary, adult education, and even to develop an environmental orientation towards education. NEP's The Program of Action or POA 1986 pointed out the importance of decentralizing core activities such as planning and management activities. The POA urges state governments to work out multi-layer planning to effective implementation of education management process. Ramamurthy Committee Report 1990. The committee gave emphasis on the importance of decentralization of education management. The committee observed that in the realm of education management, the diversity of culture and population get reflected, and one needs to take into consideration the language and cultural diversity when delivering an educational program. Hence, to make the educational management program effective, it needs decentralization of planning and other management processes from central to state level and from state to district and block level. Thus, the committee envisaged participatory educational management programs that take our nation's language and cultural diversity into consideration while formulating educational policies. The core of the participatory management lies in that fact that without the involvement of people for whom the program is designed, no educational and organization goals can be achieved or fulfilled in its true sense. Non-participatory management. This is an outdated and centralized way of educational management. In this type of management, all the decisions and policies come from a top or central authority. The students, teachers, or community members will not have any role in policy formulation. The members of the management have to execute the decisions imposed upon them by the authorities without posing any question. In this form of management, the manager is considered as an all-knowing person, and he or she will be formulating policies, deciding plans, give direction, exercise control, and takes corrective measure and often gives suggestions to the team. In non-participatory way of managing affairs, a traditional power hierarchy is maintained. Strict adherence to rules, red tapeism, and regulations are prime features of this type of management. The individual freedom, recognition, and creativity are the major drawbacks of this type of educational management. Effective educational management can be achieved only through inclusive policies and people's participation in a democratic country like India. Only by including communities, teachers, and students at every point of decision making and implementation, we can ensure that the target group benefits from the educational dreams an authority envisages for them. Let me summarize the session. In this unit, we have discussed educational management, its scope, objectives, functions, and types of educational management. The scope includes planning, organizing, directing, and motivating, coordination, and evaluation. The objectives are to offer good and qualitative education, develop healthy working environment, boost the morale of the teachers, and ensure optimum use of resources and effective management solutions. In this unit, we also discuss the functions of educational management, ranging from planning, organizing, coordinating, directing, and evaluation. We also analyzed the two different types of educational management called participatory and non-participatory management. The participatory management ensures the participation of the target group right from policy making to implementation, while non-participatory educational management is about bureaucratic and centralized way of getting the job done. Now, you can try to answer the questions given here. Why do we say educational management requires people's participation? Is educational management different from administration? Explain. What are the objectives of educational management? Why evaluation is an integral part of the function of educational management? What is non-participatory management? Now, you may go through the reference books for further reading. Educational Management, written by Adesina S. and published by Fourth Dimension Publications, United States, in the year 1990. Education in India, Problems and Perspectives, written by Dash M. and published by Atlantic Publishers, New Delhi, in 2000. Educational Management, A Unified Approach of Education, written by Sharma S. L. and published by Global India Publications, New Delhi. Thank you for watching this program. We can meet again with another topic. Till then, take care.